student and parent has this question on their mind these days. With the spread of the coronavirus, schools and colleges were the first to shut down. Examinations were cancelled and administration is shut down until further notice. In these times of uncertainty, everybody's asking themselves, is college still worth it and is online education the new normal? Let's try to answer these questions step by step. To answer the first question, is college still worth it? Let's look at some facts. College degree is important to get a job and to lead a healthy life. People have lifelong dreams to get into their dream universities or colleges. Having a college degree increases your chances at getting a better job. People who are living in poverty have a 90% chance of getting out of it if they are able to secure a college degree. Clearly, college degrees cannot be substituted with a diploma course or a simple completion of high school. Every year, there's an increase in the tuition fees that students have to pay to the college. This means that they must be increasing the quality of their education or at least the infrastructure. Sadly, that's not really the case. Colleges ideally should have tenured professors. These professors are the permanent staff of the college who are paid to research and teach the students. These tenured professors are highly qualified and have immense experience, and good professors are crucial since they build the concept of any subject in a student's mind. However, over the years, the percentage of tenured professors has fallen, while there's been a steep increase in the percentage of ad hocs or adjuncts. Ad hoc teachers have no benefits like insurance, medical, rental, etc., and their pay is significantly lesser than the tenured professors. All these factors definitely affect the teaching, and obviously they do not have much experience either. So the question is, where is our money going? Research suggests that there's been an increase in the salary of the president and chancellors of the college. Basically, instead of investing into teachers for a better quality of education, the money is going into the administration of the block, and that is saddening. While the importance of a college degree without a doubt is significant, the sad truth is that the institutions providing these degrees are looking for their own advantage over the future of the world's youth. Coming on to the next question, is online education the new normal? Well, yes, at least until this pandemic is past us. Due to the spread of this pandemic, many schools and universities are conducting online classes. Other than that, various institutes are also offering diploma online courses like graphic designing, content designing, etc. And these online courses are very cheap. The highest they charge is 6,000 for an online graphic designer course. All the other courses are cheaper than this. Diploma courses are not professional courses, and some companies may consider your diploma course, but it does not really hold much value alone. It needs to be supported by a college degree or at least some sort of experience in the field. Institutions like MAAC or Arena Animations charge a lot more than 6,000 for the same exact course. So definitely there is some upside to online learning. Schools and universities have also started with their online classes. It's important to get back on track, but the reality is not everyone has a stable Wi-Fi connection or even a Wi-Fi connection to begin with. For anyone to access an online class, it's mandatory to have a smartphone and a stable Wi-Fi or a giant data pack. People come from diverse places and every place isn't equipped with the required technology. Therefore, it seems unfair to a particular section of students. So, to conclude, we can say that the answer to both the questions asked in the beginning is yes. However, some amendments can be done to have a better and a more efficient system. For example, schools and universities can send recorded lectures to their underprivileged students via email, and they could very clearly invest more into hiring tenured professors and providing the necessary benefits to the ad hoc teachers. Well, that's all for this video. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to Explified. Also, do press the bell icon. Bye!